Michigan Out of Doors Online is brought to you in part by Big Fish Charter Services in Elginac. Experience a world-class musky fishery on Lake St. Clair for predator fishing, or a once-in-a-lifetime trip on the St. Clair River to tangle with a prehistoric lake sturgeon at Big Fish Charter Services. It's all about big fish. And by...
Quick and easy setup. Silent operation. 360 degree shooting. Triops 360, no limitations.
Welcome to Michigan Out of Doors. I'm Jenny Olson, and this week we've got another brand new show for you. It's going to be all about the islands of Michigan, that is. I'll take you up to the northern parts of Lake Huron to Drummond Island for some nighttime walleye fishing up there, and we'll also take you over to Beaver Island for some other adventures.
Well, that's right, Jenny. We do have a few more things on this week's show. We are excited for your Drummond Island story. And we're also going to go to one of my favorite corners of the state, another island here in the state of Michigan, and that is Beaver Island. You won't want to miss that. Some great fishing opportunities over there. And I believe we're going to have time for a bragging board segment as well on this week's program. So lots of good stuff on this island-themed show. Make sure you stay tuned. I'm Jimmy Gretzinger. It's time for Michigan Out of Doors.
From the first spring rains to the soft summer breeze, dancing on the pine forest floor, the autumn colors catch your eyes, here come the crystal winter skies. It's Michigan, Michigan out of doors. Someday our children all will see this is their finest legacy, the wonder and the love of Michigan, as the wind comes whispering through the trees, the sweet smell of nature's in the air. Great Lakes to the quiet stream, shining like a sportsman's dream. It's a love of Michigan we all share.
Michigan Out of Doors is presented by Greenstone Farm Credit Services, making recreational land ownership possible across Michigan and Northeast Wisconsin. Begin your land financing journey at one of Greenstone's 37 locations or visit greenstonefcs.com. By G5 Outdoors, makers of the Quest and Prime bows. Manufactured and designed in Memphis, Michigan, G5 offers archery bows, broadheads, and accessories. On the web at g5outdoors.com. By Country Smokehouse, offering a variety of meat products. Country Smokehouse is located 3 miles south of I-69 on M53, just south of Imlay City. Country Smokehouse is a meat processor, a butcher, and a destination for sportsmen.
We all have one. That perfect spot, a special place we go to smooth out the ripples of the day. Our perfect spot is calling. Our perfect spot is Pure Michigan. Your trip begins at Michigan.org.
Hi, I'm Jordan Brown, and on this week's show, we're going to highlight a couple of pretty unique fisheries around a few of Michigan's islands. And we kick things off with a story we've been trying to cover for a few years now, and that's fly fishing for carp around Beaver Island.
Within an hour of touching down on Beaver Island, my guide for the trip, Steve Martinez, and I were on his boat for what promised to be an interesting day of fishing. The plan was to target carp, not only on Beaver Island, but on several of the islands surrounding it, focusing on the flats and shallow weed cover, all via the fly rod.
So we're about 9 miles from Beaver Island over on an island called Whiskey Island. It's part of the archipelago, and we're on the lee side of the island right now. And what we're going to do is we're going to just work this shoreline across down to these points over here and catch the windward side of this point over to the north. But we're just going to slowly work this edge and look for some cruising fish and see if we can't get a fly in front of one or two of them. Today we're in northern Lake Michigan on the Beaver Island Archipelago, which is about 32 miles from Charlevoix.
by ferry or, you know, by plane. Beautiful flats, shallow water carp on a fly or conventional tackle as well. We, because of the high water, we're targeting them in the weeds and on the open water flats where they're feeding on gobies and crayfish and small nymphs. What we have here is we have carp that are here year round. So a lot of other places that I've fished carp, during the summer months when it starts to warm up, they'll go deep and they'll never come back up onto the flats or the shallows. Here, because of the makeup of the lake, we have a main lake system behind us that's cold water, and that water temperature is always cooler than it is on the other side of the island, where the reefs in the shallower water warm up and keep those fish deep. So we have opportunities throughout the whole archipelago to find fish in different water temperatures and find the warm water gains that the carp like.
This one is not happy. Tighten up some more. Come on now. I haven't had one spoon yet this year, but there's always the first. There, he's slowing down. Yeah, these things are notorious for running out a lot of line in that first initial take.
We fish the whole Beaver archipelago. We fish, you know, the hog, garden, squaw, whiskey, trout, and high. We do fish around the main isle itself, but very seldom. Mainly because of the outer islands have a little bit better reef systems. Transitions from deep water that run right up into shallow water versus them having to cross over a giant flat to get where they want to be. So Squaw Island, for example, is more of a hump where the flats are narrow, but it's surrounded by deep water, so they can get the safety of deep water within 200 yards of shallow water. Whiskey, for example, is got a little bit bigger flat, and those all have in common the deep water scenario around them, so they can come out of the cool water in a short distance. They can be in warm water that what they like, and feed and sun themselves and warm up.
Having never fished much for carp myself, I was blown away at just how powerful these fish are, and I began to understand why people come from all over the country to do this. Shortly after we landed our first fish, we were able to find a large pot of carp sitting on the warm water side of a large point. And after a little persuasion, Steve was able to get another bite.
Yeah, finally. Cast out that fish and he just charged right over to it. Grabbed it.
You know, what people don't realize is carp are one of the first fish that were planted in New York in the early 1800s. So they've been around a long time, and at that point they were stocked for food, and now they've become, you know, game fish. And we're not doing anything that's new to the sport. You know, guys have been fly fishing carp for a lot of years. But what we have come up with up here is that it's a flat style, almost it's identical to fishing the saltwater, and they are an aggressive feeder when you can find them cruising and mudding, just like they would like a redfish or a bonefish.
Yeah, took a little bit bigger fly this time. I put on about a 3-inch long crayfish imitation. He grabbed it.
Cool.
Get your turn back, buddy. There you go. There he goes. Very cool. Very cool.
With so much area to cover, catching large numbers of carp out here can be pretty difficult. And having landed two fish already, we were off to a great start. And with a large group of carp still in front of us, it didn't take long to hook fish number three.
It's a good fish. Started ripping that fly through him, and sharp strips, and he come in, grabbed it. Yep. Another good fish. 10 pounds, 12 pounds. It's not the 30 pounder we were looking for, but we'll take it. Doesn't want to give up too easily. A lot of power in those fish, boy. A lot of power. Yeah, another good fish. Another good fish.
Catching three fish on the flats via the fly rod is considered a pretty good day. And with a few good hours of fishing left to go, we still had plenty of time to catch a few more. But after watching large numbers of fish swim into the shallow weeds, we decided to switch things up a bit and try a different tactic known as dabbling, something that's relatively new to this area and is probably unlike any kind of fishing you've ever done before.
So last year, we were out with customers and we couldn't figure out exactly how to present to these fish that were in these weeds. So we just decided to try just dropping a fly. You know, out here on the flat, they're unbelievably spooky. I mean, you can't get within 20 feet without them spooking. Once they get inside the weeds, they're a lot more comfortable. They feel comfortable because they're surrounded by grass. And you can just sneak up within inches. I mean, you can stand next to a fish, a 20-pound carp at your feet, and fish to a fish 10 feet away from you that fish at your feet will never move. That's how comfortable they get in that warm water. That one didn't have any problem either. It's kind of cool though, to get water. Cool looking fish, kind of a little squirt, maybe 6 pounds, but he was an eater.
Nice.
Got cool colors on him. It's gold. They're a cool fish. Get the hook out of him here. I mean, look at that. I mean, he just gobbled that thing right up.
We ended the day having landed 5 carp, 35 miles out in the middle of Lake Michigan. To say this is a unique fishery would be an understatement, and it's one that should be on every angler's bucket list. Special thanks to Steve Martinez for showing me around the Beaver Island area, and for helping to highlight one of the great fisheries we have here in Michigan's Out of Doors.
In our next island story, we're going to head over the Mackinac Bridge, head east to Detour Village, take a ferry ride over to Drummond Island for some nighttime walleye fishing.
Captain Justin. How's it going?
Wonderful, beautiful day.
It is. So this is, we're back on Drummond Island. It's been a few years, so walleye fishing, hey?
Yes, ma'am. It's gonna be a good night. Wind's supposed to lay down here in a little while, about a couple hours. It'd be a good night of fishing.
Cool, so what have you had so far this season? It's been a little crazy?
Yeah, very inconsistent fishing. It's been good fishing, but 1 minute they're there and the next minute they're gone. We're in a mayfly hatch right now, so that makes the fish travel around quite a bit. Makes it a little more difficult, but I have to earn my keep, I guess, as a lot of people tell me, so.
Cool, all right, so who's going out with us tonight?
Well, it'll be the two of you, and myself, and my two kids are actually gonna go with us tonight, so Dylan and Trista.
Oh, cool, how old are they?
My son is 12, and my daughter is 9.
Oh, fun, all right, good deal.
So looking forward to it.
Yeah, should be fun.
My boyfriend Matt was also joining us tonight to help Captain Justin with the setup. We found our way in amongst the endless islands up here in the northernmost parts of Lake Huron, and the guys started gearing up for walleyes.
You're organized.
Well, we try to be. It surely has helped with the night fishing having these.
Did they sell them like that?
It's called Night Bite Lights. They're actually made out of Michigan, Grand Rapids, Michigan. Ray Mulder is the guy.
Dylan, what are you doing here?
I'm setting out the bait, and then I had to put a planer board on it, and we're gonna set it out at 200 feet.
Okay.
Tonight we're gonna be fishing a little bit deeper water. We're gonna be fishing with planer boards and stick baits, some deep divers, some shallow divers, and we're gonna be doing a little night fishing. So on the planer boards, we'll have some lights on tonight, help us to see them, and fish seem to bite better in the evening after dark. They come in to feed at night on the crayfish, and the crayfish come out at night, so the walleye come in out of the deeper waters into a shallower water, and they'll feed on those the entire night up until sun rises in the morning, and then they'll slide out to the deep water again.
So Trista, what's your favorite part about fishing out here with your dad?
Catching the fish and eating the fish.
All right, those are two very fun things to do. Cool, so you guys were out yesterday fishing?
Yes.
What happened?
Set out our poles, and then we caught lots of fish.
So Justin, do you get to take your family out here fishing very often?
Used to a lot more. With the charter business this year, not so much because it's been very busy, which we're thankful for. But as much as I can, as much as they want to come, a lot of times they prefer the fairer weather to come out and go fishing. But they do good. We enjoy getting out together as much as we can.
Cool. Why do you think it's important to do that?
I think it's important to instill the outdoors to children so that they learn at a young age the importance of it, the excitement of it, and that they carry that legacy on, and then also hopefully they'll teach my grandkids the same thing. If not, I will surely do that, but I think it's important for the kids to be outdoors. You know, today's technology, everything is electronics, and I think a lot of our kids don't know what the outdoors really is or what it has to offer, and so to me, this is what I say is it's my electronics, this is my hobby.
Cool.
They enjoy the outdoors.
And your kids are growing up on Drummond Island. That's got to be a little bit different too.
It is a little different. Things are certainly different around here than what most folks are used to. Of course, our winters are extremely cold, so you kind of have to learn how to bear with that. The ferry boat is kind of the big thing. If you want to go anywhere or do anything, you have to take the ferry boat, which is a dictated schedule. It only runs once an hour, so you're very reliant on that, and your return home relies on that. But the great thing about Drummond is the outdoors. If you don't like to be outside, hunting, fishing, kayaking, boating, snowshoe, hunting, skiing, cross-country skiing. If you don't enjoy any of that, this is not the place for you. You have to be outside. That's all there is to do.
Sweet! Nice work! That's a nice fish!
That sun's going down, huh?
Oh yeah, that's what it was. Look at that. Sun's down, fish are biting.
Justin was right about the nighttime bite out here off of Drummond Island. Trista was enjoying her catch, and Dylan was patiently waiting for his turn.
But tell me, you kind of help out too. You got a job on the boat. Tell me what you do to help your dad out.
I set lines, I reel the fish in, and sometimes I'll net the fish when they're at the boat.
Well, you could pretty much run this thing by yourself, don't you think?
Pretty much.
So who picks out the colors of bait?
That'd be my dad.
Okay, cool. So you know the secret colors?
Yep.
Can you tell us all of his secrets right now?
No.
Good man.
I'm not sure who loves fishing more, Justin or his kids. Justin's been fishing for fun his whole life, but this past winter he received his charter captain's license, and things have changed a bit these days.
This is my first year on a charter boat on my own. I've been taking people fishing all of my life. This is a new experience for me that I'm very excited about. I've been working on a charter boat for 4 years, but finally went out on my own this year. We moved to Drummond Island to pastor Drummond Island Baptist Church here on Drummond Island, and I also have a lawn care business and the charter business now as well. So we're busy in the summer. We only have about 5 months to make a living where we live here on Drummond, the tourist season. And so you have to kind of be busy in the summer and a little bit slower in the winter.
Is this about the size you're typically catching out here, Justin?
Fairly average there. We hope to get a couple bigger ones yet tonight.
Well, Dylan and Trista were both enjoying reeling in some nice-sized walleyes for the cooler, but the action out here tonight wasn't exactly fast and furious as we had hoped. Justin said that's par for the course this year.
Yeah, this has been probably the most inconsistent season since I've lived on Drummond. This is my seventh summer on Drummond. This year, they're moving around a lot. It's been very difficult to stay with them. We've been blessed to catch fish each trip, but it's been a little harder, a little more work to stay with the fish. And right now we have a mayfly hatch that's going on for about the last 4 weeks. And so the fish are following the flies, which just adds to the difficulty and the enjoyment of the challenge.
Good way to put it.
Do it again.
What is that? Is it Atlantic?
Dylan, give Matt that. Give Matt that, please. It'll extend one more time, Matt.
That's an Atlantic.
What?
Sweet. Are you kidding me? That's awesome.
What's that?
Atlantic salmon.
Atlantic salmon. Those are the best.
Hey, look big. I mean, you said small. I'm like, that's a big small model.
Is it Atlantic? Yep, that's an Atlantic. Yeah, we're going to keep that.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Nice job.
That is awesome.
Wow.
Trista, tell me what happened.
It was jumping out of the water a lot, and it was really hard to keep from losing the pole.
Wow, he fought, huh?
Mm-hmm. Look at
that. This is an Atlantic salmon, huh?
It's pretty.
He's beautiful.
So our last fish of the night was a huge surprise. Justin was able to show his kids an Atlantic salmon up close and personal, something that doesn't normally happen when you're after walleye. It was getting late, so we called it a night. I would chalk this up as one of the best ways to spend an evening in northern Michigan. Out on the water, slipping through the islands of Lake Huron with a couple of lucky kids whose dad is raising them up to be a part of this incredible experience we call Michigan's Out of Doors.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us this week for Michigan Out of Doors. Make sure you check us out online when you get a chance. You can do that a couple of different ways. On our website at michiganoutofdoorstv.com, where you can check out old episodes, new episodes, wild game recipes, all kinds of fun stuff happening there. Or on our Facebook page at Michigan Out of Doors TV. Lots of fun stuff coming up for you over the next few weeks.
Well, there is a lot of good stuff coming over the next few weeks here in Michigan Out of Doors. Just a couple of weeks ago, we had our whole crew out doing some muskie fishing. That's coming your way. We also are out of the port of Ludington and the port of Oscoda. So both sides of the peninsula, Lake St. Clair, up north in the UP. We've been up there chasing some fish as well. Lots of good stuff happening if you are a sportsman here in the state of Michigan. So if we don't see you in the woods or on the water, hopefully we'll see you right back here next week on your PBS station.
Michigan Out of Doors is presented by the Michigan chapters of Safari Club International. For over 40 years, SCI has been protecting hunters' rights and promoting wildlife conservation here in Michigan and around the world. SCI chapter locations can be found on the web at firstformichigan.org. By Rosie Brothers. Located in Dryden, Michigan, Rosie Brothers has been serving Michigan for over 40 years. Specializing in outdoor needs, Rosie Brothers features Kubota tractors and equipment for use in farm, home, or commercial needs. On the web at rosiebrosinc.com. By Propane, clean American energy. Propane retailers promote the safe use of Michigan-produced gas energy in homes, farms, and businesses across our great state. Learn more at usemichiganpropane.com. By Pictured Rocks Boat Cruises of Munising, exploring Lake Superior's Pictured Rocks National Lakeshore with its sandstone cliffs, caves, waterfalls, and lighthouses. Pictured Rocks Boat Cruises on the web at picturedrocks.com. Closed captioning is provided by the Michigan Propane Gas Association, clean American energy. Propane realtors promote the safe use of Michigan-produced gas to outdoor enthusiasts across our great state.
When I wander far away, a dream stays with me night and day. It's the road that leads to my home state. I am a Michigan man. Changing seasons paint the scene like rainbow trout in a hidden stream. White-tailed deer in the tall pine trees. I am a Michigan man. I am a Michigan man. Ask where I'm from and I'll show you my hands. Lord above, I love this land. I